Good morning, boys and girls. This is Max, who you met last week. And we hope that you've had a good week. We hope you've been taking part in your home study. And we also hope that you've had lots of fun as well. Today, we are going to be exploring together for a few moments the story of God keeping his promises to Abraham. But we're going to start today with a prayer. So I encourage you to lift your hands and we're going to say a prayer together and close your eyes. Let us pray. We thank you for the story of Abraham being tested by God. Increase our faith, Lord, so that we can trust you in the difficult and challenging times. Help us to be obedient to you, knowing that you know what is best for us. We also pray for all those in our world having to make very difficult decisions and choices, those in government and those working in schools and churches, shops and hospitals. Give them wisdom as they make their decisions. We ask this in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. We thank Julie and we thank Glenn and we thank Alwyn and we thank Liz for taking part in our Sunday special this morning.
The reading is from Genesis chapter 22, verses 12 to 18. Do not lay a hand on the boy, he said. Do not do anything to him. Now I know that you fear God, because you have not withheld from me your son, your only son. Abraham looked up, and there in the thicket he saw a ram caught by its horns. He went over and took the ram and sacrificed it as a burnt offering instead of his son. So Abraham called that place, "The Lord will provide." And to this day it is said, "On the mountain of the Lord it will be provided." The angel of the Lord called to Abraham from heaven a second time and said, "I swear by myself, declares the Lord, that because you have done this and have not withheld your son, your only son, I will surely bless you and make your descendants as numerous as the stars in the sky and as the sand on the seashore. Your descendants will take possession of the cities of their enemies, and through your offspring all nations on earth will be blessed because you have obeyed me." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Hi boys and girls, today I want to challenge you all to do a prayer activity. In the story of Abraham, God asked him to do something that was scary and challenging. Just like in our current situation, you might feel scared or challenged due to the restrictions of not seeing people and not being able to do the things you like doing. But just like Abraham, who had to trust God, we have to trust those in authority and do and obey, even if it upsets us. I want you to make a list of all the people who you know who have to make difficult decisions about all the things we love and do each day. People like your parents, your teachers, the government, shops and churches. I would like you all to pray for them and ask God to help them make the right decisions for each and every one of us.
The Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Well, boys and girls, thank you for watching our video today, and we hope you enjoyed it. And we thank everyone who has took part. This weekend was to be our prize day and our parish barbecues, but unfortunately that cannot take place. But we will do something special for you whenever we can return to our church buildings. Next week is going to be a very special video because we're going to have our Sunday school teachers, Lila and Fiona and Alwyn, Jennifer and Helen, our J Club leaders, Liz and Andrew and Rebecca and Kenny and Glenn and Evan and so on, all taking part so they get the opportunity to say, simply say hello to all of you and to wish you all a happy summer holidays. Over the summer, we will be running an online holiday Bible club provided by the DDYC, which is the Church of Ireland Youth and Children's Department. And I would really encourage you to get a part of that because it's an excellent package they have put in place. And we will let you know whenever that comes live on our Facebook page. Have a good week, everyone, and may God be with you this day and always.
Teaches me.